Good morning, hiking friends. It's Micey, and I'm with my friend Heather.
Good Say morning.
And we are in the beautiful town of Strawberry, Arizona, to hike down to Fossil Creek, one of the most beautiful places in Arizona. So here we go. When you hike down to Fossil Creek from Strawberry, it's 8 miles round trip. At the top, you can begin your hike on a forest road, which is old, or on the trail, which is rockier. So it's nice to start on the forest road. You can also get to Fossil Creek from I-17 and Camp Verde, but if you want to go to Fossil Creek from that side, you need a high clearance vehicle and probably even a four-wheel drive, but definitely a high clearance vehicle. I do not have a high clearance vehicle, so I'm limited to where I can access. So I come to Strawberry, and makes it a bit of a longer hike and a bit more challenging. But who doesn't like a good challenge? Do you like a good challenge?
Yes.
This is the view. A bit rubbly. Wow. Well, man, I did this hike a year ago, and it was fun. Doing it for the second time, I think, is even more fun. There's a step. Because maybe this trail is way smoother than I remember it. So far, it's really nice. Found a nice shady spot. Weather's perfect. It's like in the 50s. Great day for a hike. These trails are really pretty after it rains, because it really gets red. It's a tiny little mystery house. Not really sure what it's for. You guys, we just came upon this big, beautiful canyon. Look at this view, you guys. We are almost down to the bottom with the creek.
Oh, okay, it'll be nice to sit down and eat lunch.
We're almost halfway. We're almost to the place where we will stop, see the water, have lunch, and turn around. My hiking buddy coming up behind me. The rangers told her that since she's wearing a purple shirt, the snakes will leave her alone, which I think is just a fairy tale. Look, you guys, it's one of my favorite fences. The fun wildlife fence. Don't scratch yourself on the barbed wire. You got it.
I think Allura's only way, like last year, when they...
Really glad the weather is cool today. Well, we found what looks like a creek bed or a river bed. Who only knows? Maybe it's the East Verde River and it's all dried up. Guys, we have made it to the source of the spring that feeds the waterfall and all of the river downhill from here. Look how small it is. And it runs all year round. Very cool. We can hear the water now as it gets louder and louder. Next up should be the dam. Maybe the waterfall is the dam. And the thing that they call the toilet bowl, which people like to get into, but I don't think it's recommended because it's a whirlpool and not particularly safe. And I am all about safety. Okay, you guys, we made it to the waterfall and the toilet bowl. And I'm trying to get my finger in the shot. There, that above my finger is the toilet bowl where the water, it circles like a drain, like it's going down a toilet. It's so cool and it's beautiful. And this is fed by that tiny little spring that I showed you a little ways back. Super cool. That's a cave that you can swim into. I did swim in that cave the last time.
You did, or you didn't?
I did. And if you look at the walls, yeah, this is totally like a slot canyon. Which is the perfect spot for flash flooding to sweep a group of people away. So, happily, we're at the end of monsoon season. Found a rock wall.
yoga mat, the yoga.
I think a lot of people have the same idea.
Because it's flat, like.
It is flat. It's nice. All right. No. I think we're at least a quarter way there, though. Yeah. We have about 1 mile left to get out of this canyon. And it's been a real challenge. We're both thirsty. We're both tired. We're gonna sleep good tonight. All right, hiking friends, we're back at the car. We hiked almost 9 miles, had a total elevation gain of 1,811 feet, and we hiked that in about 8 hours. A good hike. Now we are done getting in the car and heading home. Thanks for coming along, and I will see you next time on the trail.